Question 11 is really another question that wants us to understand the meaning of what our derivative values tell us. And so this problem is telling us about two different pieces of derivative information and telling us that we've got a critical value here in the middle of those two values. So I like to just sort of draw this out on a number line, and I start by labeling my critical value, which is 10. Then conveniently, you'll notice that 9 is a point to the left of that critical value and 12 is a point to the right of that critical value. So the first thing they're telling me is that my derivative at 9 is positive. So if we remember from our derivatives, derivatives tell us slope of the graph. And so whenever the graph is increasing, that's when our derivative was positive. Whenever the graph was decreasing, that was when our derivative was negative. And whenever it went horizontal, that's what we called 0 for our derivative. And it's also what's known as a critical value. And so what we really do here is just read off that derivative data they told us. So again, 9 they told us was positive. So I put a plus sign down above 9, and that tells me that my graph was increasing coming into that critical value. And then on the other side, it's telling me that f prime at 12 is negative. So I've got a negative sign there, and negative tells me that my graph would be decreasing. After I've done that, I just kind of, it's real quick to see, this is sort of the shape that my graph would be. And so what I can see is that my graph is showing me that 10, this number in the middle here, would have been a relative maximum because it's at a peak in this situation. So our answer would be that it is B, a relative maximum, because it goes increasing into decreasing. So on any problem like this, just draw yourself a number line, lay out a couple of arrows telling you what direction the graph is going, and your answer is right in front of you.